Light in the Glass Bowl and just getting absolutely stomped by those guys, right? And at that time, you're thinking, oh, man, we just got stomped by a MAC school. We're in trouble, you know? And then we come back against Notre Dame, you know, who was ranked, I think, in the top 10, and we get a win. And 28-17, I vividly remember that day and just moments of that day and just the excitement and, I mean, what that meant for this program and for the Purdue fans. And that really set the tone for what the rest of that season would be. You know, it was a magical season. You go 9-3, and, you know, Billy Dickin had a incredible season as a fifth-year senior, you know, after all that he had overcome as a player, and, you know, leaders on defense like Roosevelt and others did such a phenomenal job. But Adrian Beasley, who's here as well, and I stay in touch with. He's in Ruston, Louisiana, so we stay in touch. But, you know, just, man, I think after that Notre Dame game, and it's so funny because you go from Toledo, getting trounced at Toledo, to then beating Notre Dame, you know, a top 10 program, and all of a sudden it's like, this is what we can be. Like, this is what we can do. You know, this is what we're all here for. And, you know, that's when the journey began.
What's the locker room like after Toledo? I mean, did you expect him to come in and yell and scream?
I mean, what I remember about Toledo is that we couldn't stop them, you know, and fourth quarter rolls around, it's like 36-7 or something like that, and then he looks at me and is like, you're in, you know, as a true freshman. I'm thinking, all right, and I remember I ran 22 plays, 21 of them were passes, and the only run was like a reverse to Vinny, where he scores. So that was my introduction to college football, and I was like, all right, this could be a wild ride.
Set you up for the 83 pass a year later,
yeah,
right?
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. Yeah.
Let me ask you a question just about Jeff Brohm. What do you think so far about the job he's done so far?
I think Coach Brohm has done a tremendous job. I think he's changed the attitude and the culture, for sure. I mean, there's excitement. You know, there's energy. There's a belief that, you know, we can compete with anybody. We can win any game. And it started with that Louisville game. I think they got a lot of people excited around here. You know, that's a great program. And with the Heisman Trophy winner quarterback winning and competing against those guys, really had a chance to win that game, you know. And then rattle off two really big wins, and obviously, you know, face a tough Michigan opponent and lose. But I mean, I think he's given us a ton to be excited about. I think that I think the players have bought into the program. I think he's, you know, made an instant impact, you know, which is hard to do. And I think he's got a great staff, and really just again, it's the belief and the attitude that we can compete with anybody.
Do you sense any similarities between 97 and now?
I do. It's a new era of Purdue football. It was back then with Coach Taylor, and here we are 20 years later, it's a new era with Jeff Brohm. I think that's the way all the guys that were part of that had a chance to be a part of something like that. We see that and feel that with this team and with Coach Brohm. I guess.
Thanks, Drew.